Hello everyone, in this video, I will explain how to implement PCA, that is Principal Component Analysis model, using the Vine dataset. So first of all, let's have a look on the dataset, that is the CSV file. So this is our CSV file. It contains the amount of chemicals present in the vines, like alcohol, malic acid, ash, alkanity, magnesium, total phenols, all these chemicals which are present in vine, and this numbers indicates the quantity of the chemicals which are present in the vine, and according to that they have segmented the customers according to that, like which amount of customers take how much amount of alcohol, how much amount of malic acid. According to that we have segmented the customers, and we have segmented the customers into three segments, like 1, 2, and 3. Now moving to the coding part. So this is the code. Let's first run the code so that you'll get an idea of what will be the output. So this is the output for the training set, and this is the output for the testing set. I will explain about these outputs in detail afterwards in this video. Now let's first understand what is PCA model. PCA is one of the feature extraction technique of dimensionality reduction. Dimensionality reduction basically means that from the independent variables of the data set, PCA extracts p less than equals to m new independent variables that explains the most of the variance of the data set regardless of the dependent variable. So PCA is the unsupervised model, as we don't consider dependent variable. So you can once again you can see the data set over here. Here the column from alcohol to proline, all these are independent variable, but this customer segment is dependent variable because it depends on all these columns, like alcohol content, malic acid content, etc. So in dimensionality reduction, basically what we do is, since we have a lot of columns over here, so we will reduce the columns into 2 or 3 or 4 columns, like we have 13 columns, then we can reduce the column to into 2 columns which are quite useful. Hence the features which we have extracted, like the features which are useful and we are extracting, are called the principal components. So finally, as I have initially mentioned, that we will be extracting two independent variables. Now again, coming to the coding part, first of all we need to import the libraries, like NumPy for arrays, matplotlib for plotting the graphs, pandas for importing the data set. So after importing the libraries, finally we will have to import the data set using pd.read.csv. So we have imported the data set, that is wine.csv. Finally we have imported the independent and dependent variables. So now we have imported the sklearn model selection class to split the data set into training and test set. Again, Here we have used feature scaling, which is quite required for PCA. Like we need to scale some features because we don't need the useless feature. So here we have done that. We have divided the data into training set and test set after feature scaling. So now I will be printing this. Get the output as. So here, after feature scaling, this is the output. You can see over here. We have extracted some of the features. Now we have applied PCA. So now we have imported the right class, that is scaler.decomposition, to use PCA. We have created an object of this class. So finally we have created an object, that is PCA.fit of this class. Fit.transform. So finally, after printing this X train, after applying PCA, we have printed the X train value. So here we are getting two values. As I have mentioned above, that we are getting only two independent, we will be extracting only two independent values, that is PC1 and PC2. Here you can see the output like here, PC1 and PC2. We have extracted only two independent variables. So now, after that, we have used logistic regression model to solve the classification problem. Since we have classified the customers into several segments, like 1, 2, 3, according to the alcoholic, according to the content of the wine or the chemicals of the wine they prefer. So this is the code for that. We have introduced logistic regression model as a classifier. So finally we are predicting the test set results, and I will be printing the results. So after printing this result, I've got the value like, so I've got this value. This includes the, this 1, 3, 2, 1, 2, this includes the customer segments, that is the customers which belongs to the particular segment, like the customer here belong to the first segment, the customer here belong to the third segment, and so on. Second segment and so on. Finally, we are making the confusion matrix. So here now we are, I'm printing the confusion matrix, that is CM, after executing the code. I've got the output like this. You can see this is the confusion matrix. Here we have got the confusion matrix of 3x3 dimension. The correct values are organized in the diagonal line from top left to the bottom right of the matrix. So this 14, 15 and 6, the adding the summation of these three elements, they show the correct values of the prediction. Now in this code, which I have highlighted right now, we are visualizing the training set results using the matplotlib or scatterplot. So we have used red, green, and blue color. You can see the output like here. Here you can see three colors. In training set, you can see three colors like red, green, and blue. Red belongs to customer segment 1, and blue belongs to customer segment 3, and green belongs to the customer segment 2. So in training set, the graph has been plotted into two independent variables, like PC1 and PC2. So finally, coming to the testing part, you can see the logistic regression which we have used over here in testing part. Now in test set, we have also again we have used red, green, and blue. And once again, I'll show you the output. Here, since we have 97% accuracy, so some of the customers from the second segment, like green color, are in this red portion, red region. So here we are lacking our prediction. Here also, here, like the customer from this green region are then the red region. So we have only 97% accuracy. That's why it's happening. So thank you so much. I'm done with the video and the topic as well.